Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Dead March difficulty. We're still playing the Blood and Wine DLC and today we're gonna do a little Gwent tournament. But for that, I have a lot of work ahead of me. But first, we're at the Pheasantry, so the bar we've been to a few times by now. So here we are, I can show you that on the map actually. So there we go, the southwest side of the western southern side of Beauclair. Right over there, it's marked as a tavern, so that's where we're gonna start this off. So, let's head inside and see who we can find, because we're looking for a specific gentleman in here, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe upstairs? Ooh, hello there. Might be a bit too early, so let's meditate first. There we go. There's a bard, so there seems to be a bit more people right now. Let's take a look. Bon vivant, he's not named. Nilfgaardian nobleman. She's having a great time apparently, but that's probably not who we're looking for. Jesus Christ, there's a lot of people in here. Even people that are inside of each other. Yep, those women are one. What the? This woman's dress is upside down. Luckily, I don't see her upper legs for some reason. Jesus Christ, where is this guy? Oh, there we go. I found a poster of the Gwent tournament here on the wall. I'm going to show you on the map in a minute. So never have you seen such a tournament, for such a tournament's never been held. All lovers of Gwent are invited to come compete against players from all over the world. In addition, this tournament shall be your chance to play the new and exciting Skellige faction. Count Monnier will be expecting you at the Pheasantry. We were there in a minute.
Invitation to a Gwent tournament, due to take place at the Pheasantry, organized by a certain Count Monnier.
So we were there a minute ago, but apparently we needed to check out one of these posters first. I'm going to show you on the map really quickly. So right there in the center of Beauclair, near the Grand Palace, marker is a notice board, and across from that notice board is where I found the poster on the left there. So that's where you can start the Gwent tournament. But now let's go to the Pheasantry again and talk to this Count Monnier. There's actually one on the bottom of the Pheasantry as well, so probably plenty of posters that you could have checked out beforehand that would allow you to find the Count. And now the Count will magically have spawned over here. One slot free for anyone willing to play the Skellige deck. There we go.
I assure you, Skellige is just as strong as the other factions. It shall soon be considered canon. Of this I'm certain.
I don't know. Always been an Ilfgaard man myself. I must give it some more thought.
So there we go. This man wants to add another faction to the Gwent game.
By all means, you've come to the right place. I am Count Martin Monnier, organizer in chief.
Okay, so let's have a little chat about that.
Our tour is more than mere diversion. We've a mission, see? To spread word of my brother's brainchild, Skellige, a new Gwent faction.
Okay. So, where'd you get the idea?
New deck? Where'd you get the idea? I mean, why bother?
All Beauclair knows me as a great lover and promoter of Gwent. My brother, dead for some time now, was known to be the same. We shared another great passion, travel. Spent a great many years at sea in our youth, marking out our territory in multiple corners of the world. Yet the one that truly grabbed us by the stones were the Skellige Isles. The stormy sea, consumed by a fever, a suicidal awe, dashing itself against somber cliffs. That is the image I retain. It and others like it inspired my brother to devise the new faction.
Okay, interesting. So tell me about the faction itself.
These new cards. Tell me something about them.
Their design embodies the Isle's spirit. The rage-filled potency, the rough, brutal beauty. Famed Skelligers, heroes of lore, berserkers and beasts, ogle us from the cards. Bran Twirsek is the faction's leader, of course.
And the other famous Skelligers?
Hjalmar and Serison Kreite, naturally. Though not conjoined. Also Heimdall the hero, the venerable druid Ermion, the list goes on.
So Bran is the original king, so that's why it's pretty interesting that he's the faction leader. So why don't sign up, take part in the tournament.
The tournament? Where do I sign up to play?
right here with me. I've one slot open, but there's a condition. You must use cards of the Skellige faction.
And there's the rub. This is why I'm going to record this in two parts.
I've already asked a great many seasoned players to do the same. Alas, all fear novelties, disdain process, care too much for the climax for winning. So they insist on playing with their tried and true decks.
Long story short, you need a sucker who'll risk it. Take a stab at proving Skellige's no worse than the established decks. Best way to do that'd be to win this tournament using your brother's cards.
We understand one another perfectly, I see.
Behold, yeah, indeed.
This trophy, standing stiff and strong. It could be yours if you win.
That looks like something I want to win.
Could look great in my house. On the sideboard, maybe.
So, yeah, deal. We'll play using the Skellige deck.
All right, I'll give it a shot. Play using the new faction.
That is an exceedingly good rub to my loins.
Excuse me?
Just one small adjoinder. I can only provide you a basic Skellige deck. My brother, alas, gave away or lost many key cards.
No chance I can win the tournament with these cards?
An issue easily resolved. You must simply face local Gwent competitors, win the missing cards from them. Besides, it would be very good practice for the tournament itself. Here, the cards I can spare you. Take them, please. The rest I keep for myself, for I too intend to play as Skellige.
So there we go, and that's the problem. So never fear, Skellige's here, and that's what I'm gonna have to do next. Because as you can see, in the top right, 0 out of 24. I need to beat, I think it's 19 that I need to beat, because the strength is calculated in a different way. But that's the reason I'm gonna... This is still gonna be one long episode about the Gwent tournament. I'm gonna have to record this in two parts because I'm gonna have to... Well, I think I need to defeat 19 other Gwent players in Toussaint. So that's gonna take a while, so I can't really record that in one sitting. And after that I'm gonna return and record the rest of the tournament. Well, the tournament itself. But before that, I'm gonna have to see you later. But for you guys, it's just gonna be a few seconds. So, see you! What's up, everybody? My name is Trophonet, and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Deathmarch difficulty. We're again playing the Blood and Wine DLC, and I have a bit of a confession to make. I have a Gwent problem. So, in the time between two episodes ago and now, I started the Gwent tournament quest, but for that we needed to assemble a completely new deck, the Skellige deck. And if you gather all the cards, you get a trophy. I have a Gwent problem. And it seems like a lot of players are really mad about the fact that someone added a new faction. So, hello, sirs, can I pass? Hello? Are they gonna hit somebody? Hello, Mr. Guard. Hello?
Welcome. The tourney is on the way. Might I glance at
of course
deck?
You can.
Sure, here.
So in a minute I'm going to show you what deck I'm actually using, what composition I'm using.
An impressive array. Count Monnier waits inside. You may.
I might actually wait Thanks. Until we finished our first match, but otherwise, here we go. Because we're actually forced to use the Skellige deck, which makes this quite interesting. Because otherwise I would have gone back to
Pleasure
the Northern
to
Realms
you,
deck again.
The Skellige faction, how do you find it?
Not my favorite, that's true, but great, I like it a lot. Not that I ever played a match
that's
with
great.
It so far.
Faction's a pleasure to play.
I'm glad to hear it.
Any specific tournament rules? Mind giving me an overview?
Firstly, might I introduce the contestants. Superb Gwent players all, hailing from the world's farthest corners. Hamal Ochen Dankbali. An Ophir.
Hello, sir.
Eric van Frog, a patrician from Novigrad. And lastly, we are proud to welcome a Skelliger.
Ye blind? Not Skelliger, Skelligirl, dammit!
Naturally, no offense meant. Agnetha Skolt, her effer charming isle temperament in evidence, along with assorted beats, baubles, ropes.
And she's gonna be mad
as
if you're
to
gonna
rules,
keep antagonizing her.
Each player adopts a faction they cannot change for the tourney's duration. Lose a match, and you're eliminated.
Okay.
The winner from among you shall advance to the semi-final to face the winner of the tourney's previous edition. His Excellency the Ambassador of the Empire of Nilfgaard, Master von...
I'm guessing he's going to play Nilfgaard, but I think he was shown in the introduction as well.
Me, your humble servant.
Hands off our
Gwent! Okay.
No new fucking factions!
What do they want?
Protesters have gathered outside. Quite a few, it seems.
Hands off our bloody game! We didn't want any new factions! Mighty, you dozy cunt! Stop diddling with dwarves!
You dozy cunt!
Change cannot always please everyone. Gwent traditionalists resent my efforts to expand the canon to include Skellige, but we shall pay them no mind.
Yes, because we're gonna likely win everything. What factions will the others play?
Mind telling me what factions the others will be playing?
It is no secret. Erik van Frog will play the Northern Realms. His Excellency, in a flush of patriotism,
of course he did.
Hamal Ochendangbali will play the Monster Steck, and Agnetha Skold has chosen Skoyatel. Yours truly, of course, shall await the winner with a Skellige deck. I'm determined to prove its fact.
Interesting. So, let's begin.
Ready to start, if everybody
else is. Means we're probably looking at 3 to 4 matches.
The Herald shall soon announce the tourney's start.
Here we go. Ooh, look at that fancy trophy.
Let the tourney begin! In round one, Agnetha Skult faces Erik von Vrog. And Geralt of Rivia plays Hamal on Gangbali.
The monster deck first. That shouldn't be that much of a problem.
A wager would you wish to make?
What did you have in mind?
Weapons do I collect, and your sword of silver my eye has caught. Should I win, I should take it. Should I lose, to you another equally precious shall I give?
Interesting. Agreed. Because I'm going to try to beat all of them, of course, and... I think if I'm not mistaken, there are no save points between the matches, so that might be interesting. So, quickly going to show you my deck. So we have King Bran as my leader, 3 decoys, a Commander Horn, a Clearweather, and 3 Skellige Storms. Because the Skellige Storms will be in handy, because a Skellige Storm is like the normal weather cards, but it combines torrential rain with impenetrable fog. So both the center and lower rows are going to be, the back rows are going to be reduced to 1. But with King Bran, I only lose half my strength of the units. So that's going to be very interesting. Then Ciri, Yennefer, the standard, Valen Tretemer, Olgierd, Dandelion, the mysterious elf, of course, Avalok. And then we have Olaf, Hjalmar, Saris, Ermion, 3 clan on crate warriors, 3 light longships, 1 clan dimmed pirate, which is actually a very interesting card because it combines the scorch card with a normal unit card. And 3 war longships, clan drummond shield maiden, all 3 of them, 3 young berserkers, 1 burner bran, drake bondu, the bard that improves your kind of like dandelion but improves the back row, and then Kambi, the golden rooster. So here we go. I'm very interested, because this is my first time I'm actually using the Skellige deck. 1 decoy is good, Skellige Storm is good, Kambi is good. Then I'm going to have to see what kind of special cards I have. I should actually just make way with... What else do I have? The Younger Berserkers are a waste at the moment, but I'm going to remove the Shield Maiden. Then we have Saris, and then the... because I have a Skellige Storm, so might as well remove my War Longship. That was a mistake, but never mind. Okay, first turn. I'm gonna immediately start with Kambi, because that card summons an extra unit on the map. And I'm gonna have to be smart about this. If I use... If I use this already, might as well be in the advantage. I'm actually wondering, if I use 2 cards, normally... Because the Skellige ability is that you keep 2 cards on the map. But I just want to try out if that actually works completely. With strong cards such as Olaf himself as well. So yeah, let's try this. That boosts everybody up, and then I'm just gonna pass, and hopefully those two right cards will stay, because Cambi is gonna be replaced by another card. There we go. And then Skellige ability? No? Oh, that is... what? I thought the Skellige ability was... that we could get two more cards after... oh shit, that was not something I intended to do. So 11, but it's a hero card. That's actually interesting. I never used that combi card before. There we go. That's the witches. I'm gonna leave those there for a second. I'm not getting any spice, which is really, really annoying. I think I'm gonna just have to go full out on this one. So let's put her back on, Yennefer. And then let's see, what would be... Olaf would be very nice, although for now... I don't really have a use for him. Okay, that's also 6. Which is good, if they're all 6... oh, 4. I'm gonna actually use the Scorch card. And just remove... that's 4 cards it removes, so... oh shit! Oh no, of course. Shit, that was stupid. That was stupid. I think I'm gonna lose immediately now. That only buffs that. God damn it. Here we go then. Okay, that's a weird decision. The vampires. Jesus Christ. This is just gonna hurt me, but never mind. Oh, decoy. Yeah, great. I'm gonna actually use a decoy of my own. Skellige Storm. And now this is gonna be interesting. I'm gonna pass. But I wonder who gets the first turn next round. Oh, and one monster card stays on the board. I think I lost. Oh, never mind. Never mind. I think I just won. Because now... this is gonna kill both mine and his. Oh, and myself as well. That is bullshit. Seems like I got a better hand now. I'm actually gonna immediately start off with Saris. And that should make him pass, hopefully. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna pass immediately. And they are going to as well. Okay, that gives me that. And I don't need to play this smart. I'm gonna start off with one of the warriors, the Uncreate warriors. Okay, Trisco's on the board. I'm gonna have to be really careful here. There's a lot of these cards I just want to keep on hand. I'm not going to use the shield maidens again. I could. Just trying to take out most of their troops. And reuse Burna a few times. That could actually work. So let's use a shield maiden. There we go. There we go again. Because those are going to go to the graveyard anyway. So if I use a decoy on Burna, because he doesn't have any more spies aside from the ones he just used. And we have a commander's horn. That's not bad. Okay. So now I can use Burna again. And use another shield maiden. There we go. And he's gonna put that over there as he usually does. Okay. Probably has some sort of scorch card in his deck. So I'm probably gonna just use Olaf and try that out. Okay, vampires. I'm waiting for the inevitable smackdown, so Dandelion? That's 83. And then adding more spiders. I'm hoping he's gonna use something really, really fast, because I'm starting to run out of options here. Could use the clear weather just to toss a card. And then hope he starts using a use a commander sworn already. He might not have anything else, actually. I'm gonna double up on my Clan Drummond warriors. Okay. Do I use... I'm just quickly counting. I use lose half everything if I use that card. Six. He can get the witches back home. So that's 3 times 6, 18 extra. Even if he doubles that all up, I should be the stronger one out of the bunch. And then I could still use Biting Frost. So let's use Valentratenmer and destroy his one vampire. Restore a card from your discard pile. And now, should I or shouldn't I? So 4, that's 12, 24. So that just adds 24 if he doubles that up, putting him at 95. So I don't think, unless he has a Scorch card, I should be fine. I'm just gonna have to guess. That's the vampires. And I won the round. Oh, oh, never mind. I won already. Okay. That was good. So yeah, it definitely pays off to keep your deck limited, because I removed a few of the cards.
Wager a sword against you, no, I not. Clearly to guide me the universe.
Ooh, fancy.
Here, you may it serve well.
Okay.
Never have lost if you hadn't cheated.
And my land, folk who slander like that don't live long. But we don't let them.
Okay, take it easy.
Accuse me of cheating again, and I'll cut your tongue out.
Enough. Hands yes, indeed.
As Gwent is a gentleman's sport, we expect all its players to demonstrate impeccable manners, and we cannot tolerate any disturbances.
Okay, fine
Thus,
enough.
By decision of Count Monnier, the contestants from Novigrad and Skellige are hereby disqualified.
Well, gentlemen, the Novigrad sport. Guy lost anyway, so...
Well, I'm a lady, and we ladies don't give a flying fart about a tourney where any measly prick can accuse us of cheating.
So that's good, because that means...
With round one completed, the standings are as follows. Agnetha Skolt and Eric Van Vroeg both disqualified. Geralt of Rivia has defeated Hamal Ong Denbali of Ophir. In the semi-final, Geralt shall face the defending champion, Ambassador Vaughn.
So that means we need to play one last match, and it doesn't seem I can save. Okay. So that means we're going to have to win these all in a row, which sucks. Hopefully I get a good draw this time. Okay, Combi, clear weather card. We don't have any of the fancy combinations. Could get rid of the clear weather card. I think I'm going to. Young Berserker, goddammit, I don't have Ermion. I'm just gonna toss the Young Berserker again. And I get another Young Berserker, of course. Never you mind. And I don't have a decoy, shit. Ah, fuck. I'm just gonna lose immediately. Okay, he starts off with Dandelion for some reason. I'm definitely gonna use... I'm gonna use Combi on the second round. So if he dies, I'm gonna get that back in the third round, getting extra cards that the Nilfgaardian might not have. I'm gonna force him to pass on this round, hopefully. So Valen Tretemar is not going to do him much good. Do I toss the Berserker already? I don't think I should. I can reuse the clan on crate warriors if I want to, because I have two healers. So that might not be such a bad idea. Leto. Then I'm just going to use my double uppers. Because he doesn't have another... Oh, shit. I know what he's going to do. He's going to put Valen Tretemar back on the board. But that means he used his decoy already. Which is kind of good. Okay. I'm going to have to play this smart now. If I use... all geared now. I think... yeah, okay. All geared now. He's going to use the decoy... oh, to get Danny... oh, fuck. He's just going to pause. He's using the decoys to get his cards back. Ah, damn it. That was a stupid decision. Yeah, okay. Just going to let him do that. Yeah, okay. Guess correctly. He paused there. So now the question is he going to use spies? I was going to put Cambi on the board immediately, so that's not a question. Dandelion is back already. Which isn't that bad, because I still have Valen Tretemar if needs be. I'm just going to toss the Berserker. Or not? Do I toss the Berserker? I think I am going to toss the Berserker, because I have a chance that I get them back. Draw a card from your opponent, discard pile. Okay. Which one did he take? Oh, that was one of the warriors he took. Oh, that was nasty. Skellige Storm then, I suppose. I'm just tossing cards now, if you're wondering what I'm doing. I'm just tossing cards. He still has Valen Tretemar, doesn't he? That is interesting. I could get... can't get Ciri back, but I could get Olgierd back. Interesting. Just gonna get that on the board so Yennefer doesn't lose any attack points. I'm just gonna put Olgierd on the board. That gives the combi one attack power for some reason, but... so the Golden Rooster has some damage to it, so that doesn't lose him any points. Then use Burna and the Uncrate Warrior. I'm gonna just let him spam his cards, because yeah, otherwise I'm just gonna lose anyway. So if I use the Valen Tretemar card now, he's going to lose 12 points, but of course he still has 4 cards as well. Oh god. And Scorch, of course. It's not that bad, because now he... ooh. And that just transforms, and now I'm going to get 2 random cards back, and that's it. That's it. So that's... those 19 points is everything I'm going to have. Valen... oh fuck. Oh, damn it. Oh, damn. Yeah, okay, it's over. It's over. God damn you. Ermion combo. Ermion with a young Berserker might turn that guy around. There we go. Brrr. That is something. Might as well use the Skellige Storm now in a minute. Man, I really don't have good cards on this round. If he starts using spies, I'm gonna be furbernuckled. Skellige Storm? Giving me the advantage? Okay, spy, thank you very much. Just gonna use my decoy on that spy. Give me that back. that girl, the Rivier. Bum 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 bum. Could destroy his one guy over there, but I might just wait a bit. We just command horn, just gonna wait with that as well. Don't waste too many cards on your first turn, Vinny. Trophy nut, don't do it. Valiant Retmer makes the difference the biggest, so if I use that, there we go. Chances are he uses Scorch. Okay. Still makes this. Wait, Nilfgaard wins ties, right? Just gonna have to use one more. Is he gonna use draw a card from your opponent discard pile? What did he just take? Fallon Tretimer, probably. Okay, so he's gonna use that next turn. Yeah, there we go. That destroys my Clan Drummond warrior. And now he's decoying. Ooh. Ah, that is so annoying. Oh, I didn't even win the first round. So yeah, I need to win this. Oh, shit balls. Is there anything interesting in the discard pile? Doesn't look like there is. So let's use the spy. Your opponent passed. Okay. So that is an easy one, if I'm not mistaken. If I use Scorch, I get... It destroys Valiant Retimer, leaves those two alone, but that gives me one more point. Allow me to win this round with just as many cards as he has. Wondering if he has a healer, so I get those two back. Shouldn't have... That combi card. Oh, should have placed that on them. Oh, damn it. Could have won this easily. Oh, damn it. Okay, never mind. Let's just use it. Another waste of a card, and yeah, there he goes. He's gonna use the spy probably. Yeah, I'm gonna get the most out of that in a minute. I'm going to use the commander's horn. He doesn't have Valiant Tretimer. He might have another Scorch, but I think he used that already as well. Nope, never mind. Shit. Okay. I'm gonna lose again. Oh, the Scorch card. There we go. He has another 10 cards. And it gives him 21 and then two more cards. I'm wondering if he can pull this off. I'm really curious. I'm just gonna let it go. So that's the 10 card I knew he still had. Then 6, that's 27. Yes! Yes! Okay, that was incredibly close.
Your Excellency.
Jesus Christ, my heart.
The pleasure was mutual, I assure you. Congratulations.
I'm gonna have to play another round, I think.
Stop desecrating! Okay. Gwent!
Death to any and all new factions!
Seems there's some trouble brewing.
Scoot, Olius, off your asses and hide to Skellige. Ye ill-loving seal slappers.
Please remain calm and stop the verbal attacks.
Stop your mum from fucking ferrets, Mollier.
Stop your mum from fucking ferrets. Okay, what exactly is the problem?
Maybe instead of hollering threats, you ought to just explain what it is you want.
We've said it plenty of times, yet no one ever listens.
Got me listening.
Gwent's an ancient pastime. Its rules were set ages ago.
Exactly. Determined in keeping with the laws of nature.
There should be 4 factions. That is the optimal number. We'll not tolerate the introduction of any others. It would disgrace the tradition.
Aye, leave our Gwent the fuck alone.
Enough of this. Didn't come here to jabber but to break fucking heads in defense of tradition.
Come on.
Okay. By the way, I kind of equipped this gear as a joke. Okay. Can I swap? Oh shit. Here we go again. Can I get my sword back, please? They're using. Okay, this is fucking hectic. I can't eat though. Oh, this one is down. Oh, I'm dead.
Had enough? Still got the urge to add new factions?
Enough. Okay.
I shall summon the guard.
So apparently that didn't do anything negative.
Sure, you can shut this tournament down, but there'll be another, with who knows what new rules. If you don't like them, don't enter. Play somewhere else however you want, but you'll never stop other folk from playing however they like.
Bollocks!
Like my good friend Zoltan Chive says, if one says you're talking bollocks, they could be right, they could be wrong. But if multiple say you're talking bollocks, well, you probably are. So let's take a vote. Who else here thinks I'm full of it?
Zoltan Chive! Haven't seen that rascal in ages. How's he
doing? Oh, there we go, the magic word. So by the way, kind of forgot to mention this, but I equipped the bear school gear. Not because we did it in the previous episode, well, kind of. But it kind of looked amazing, and I grew his hair longer as well, just to have this, uncut man walk into a fancy Gwent tournament. Be glad to tell you, over a bottle, that sounds like a way to ease over the,
was in Novigrad last I saw
the anger.
Be glad to tell you more over a flask of something strong.
Attention, everyone! Our outing's taken a new turn! We're to sit and drink vodka with Zoltan's pal!
Sounds like a plan!
Gentlemen, wait. We've still the final round of the tournament to play.
Final? Fuck that! I, Yaki Raffenberg, do hereby declare my participation in this tournament. And I demand to play the victor. We'll settle whether this Skelliger faction's worth a flaming bag of shit! Once and for all!
Okay, can I save
agreed,
somewhere in between?
Please, show some patience.
Oh, I probably...
first play.
God damn it.
A pre-fight.
I probably could have saved during the fight. God damn it. God damn it. I fucked myself
in,
over.
Pre-final, Count Monnier, representing the Skelliger faction, shall face Geralt of Rivia, also playing with a Skelliger deck.
I'm running over an hour right now. Can I save? Come on.
Skelliger in the final, and played by both contestants.
Good luck.
Yeah, good luck. I'm gonna die. Do I keep the Biting Frost on? I think I'm gonna keep the Biting Frost on. There we go. Your opponent will go first. One decoy is enough. All three maidens. That is great. Damn it, that's a really bad hand. Mysterious Elf. What was that last card? Oh, one of the warriors. Come on. Mysterious Elf, help me out here. Give me two nice cards. Oh, another Berserker. That's really good. So I'm gonna put... What does Ermion actually do? Of all Berserker cards on the same row, okay. So that's my first attempt then, I suppose. There we go. A war longship, not that bad. And then I'm gonna use the Berserkers. Arrar. Okay. Saris, that is painful. Because that doubles everything up, especially with Dandelion over there. Okay. I have two healers, so I might actually just use another Berserker. There we go, that doubles them up. Oh, he passed. Interesting. Not gonna use the decoy on the Berserkers. Because I can do that on the healer. Can I get further than any of that? Don't think I can. So yeah, he blew a lot of his cards on that. But now all my berserkers have transformed. They're going to go back to the graveyard. I'm going to have to be fast with my resurrecting. Because if he uses his leader ability, I'm going to be fucked immediately. Okay. So the light longships, I can easily counter that with the Skellige Storm. And now I'm going to have to start healing. So let's get the first berserker back on the board. Ooh, there's Yennefer. Interesting. What is he going to come back with? Okay, the warship. Not that bad. Then I'm going to use Burn Up Bran to get the other berserker. Double that up. Now he's going to use Scorch, naturally. But as you can see, I'm just weakening his cards. So now I can use Burna again. He passed. That is interesting. Because that means if I use a Skellige Storm, how much does he have left? 11. So the smartest thing to do here would be to keep Burna and just put the warrior on the map. There we go. Now we have a bit of cards left for the final round, and now we're both gonna have cards back on the map. There we go. But he has a young berserker and I have the better one. Before we do anything, no, he can shuffle the cards back from the graveyard, so I'm not gonna even wait with putting the other berserker on the map, because otherwise I'm not going to be able to use Burna again. So that's pretty good. For me, that is. Then we're going to use the Shield Maiden. Commander's Horn, yes. Yes, the only thing he can do now is put back some his cards in the graveyard back in his deck. But that's not going to help him out in this one. Yes. Yes. Three matches in a row, one. Okay, is that it? Oh no.
Congratulations.
Right, we need to still win against the dwarf.
Man has won, playing the best faction to boot.
Thanks. Good game.
Skellige won. What a bundle of pish. Tournament's not done. Now it's my turn.
Can I save, please?
That is what we agreed. Let us resolve our differences.
Please.
Now to determine the ultimate victor. Geralt of Rivia, playing the Skellige faction, shall face Yaki Raffiberg, playing Skoyatel,
okay.
Let the better man or dwarf win.
I might be able to win that. Okay, I think my deck is pretty good. It's faced a lot of hardships. So I removed all the long ships just to get a more focused deck. And I removed the booster for the back row as well. And I removed one Skellige Storm, so I could have a bit of a more focused deck. Okay. Skoyatel faction goes first, so that's good. I have a decoy, I have Cambi, I have two berserkers, and I have Ermion. That is amazing. I only have one warrior. So I might as well lose the warrior. And get another warrior in return. Do that again, and I have Burna. Okay. Burna is good. Burna is very, very good. Because we have a decoy as well, so we could get those cards back. So, Ermion, let's start with that again. There we go. Could use Scorch if things get too hairy on the other side of the map. But right now it's looking like I'm going to be able to force an early pass. Let's transform my berserkers right away. If they get destroyed, so be it. So that's still, that 12th card is still the biggest one on the map, actually. Now I'm going to be a bit tactical about this. I'm going to use All Geared and let him boost the berserker. So now the strongest card is still that 12 card on the opposite side. Do I use Olaf already? I could use the Biting Frost as well. And then just blatantly pause. No, I think I should. Because I have ways to getting those Berserkers back. So even if he uses a Scorch card, I can Scorch him right back as well, by the way. So yeah, let's do that. It's gonna double them up, putting them to 17. Yeah, because for some reason that one attack point doesn't come true further. Does that add any 6 cards? No, it doesn't. Fallen Tretimer would have been really handy here, but let's just use Biting Frost, because there are so many close quarters, close combat units on the map. So he passed. Do I use a decoy? I don't think I should use a decoy. Just gonna wait with what he does. Yeah, just gonna do that. Could use the decoy to get one Berserker back, but I don't think that's worth everything. So let's put Combi on the map. That's immediately what I'm gonna do. So he's gonna resurrect something. That one, apparently, for some reason. Do I just nuke the guy's board right now? Because I only have very strong cards in my graveyard at the moment. I'm gonna use Olaf. So if I just nuke the board right now, he loses his advantage a bit. Because I can only do the same right now. So if I use Burna, I could probably get... I'm gonna get all geared back. Just gonna see what happens after that. So just choose Burna. And then get all geared back. Might seem a bit weird, but I think that's the smartest thing to do right now. Ooh, he's gonna resurrect something else. Okay, does that activate his ability again? No. So nuking the board doesn't really have a use right now. I'm just gonna use the decoy on Burna. Padding this out a bit longer. Etne. So we only has 2 cards left. Yeah, I'm just gonna pause. Oh, gold. So he's gonna stop it as well. He has 2 cards left. I have that. I get 2 extra cards. There we go. That's what I was counting on. I get another Berserker on the map. He's gonna put Geralt on, which is good. I'm not gonna use my Scorch card, because that's gonna just obliterate my own row. And then use Olaf on the Berserker. Valen Tretimer is good. That just destroys all gear. Didn't really have a use with him as well. And he passed. Yes, I won everything. I won. I'm just going to use my last card. I'm just going to use the Berserker again. Fuck you. There you go. Scoia'tael in the face. And pass. Yes. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
Thanks. Good game.
Wow, that was tough.
Blasters. What hurts most is fucking Skellige won. But as they say, tough shit. Congrats.
Wow, that was 4 games in a row.
Come on, lads. Let's get soused.
That took me an hour and a half again.
Stay, for I wish to treat you all to a tipple.
A tipple?
We must toast the premier of the new faction. And if anyone wishes to play a friendly match of Gwent, I see no reason why not.
Please not. I want to save. I just want to get this over with right now. Give me that
Thank
trophy.
Thank you for everything, Witcher.
Yeah, you're welcome. No problem. Didn't all go as planned, but no problem.
No problem. Had fun.
You Look at him, the scruffy man.
A true Gwent master. Here, the grand prize. You earned it.
Yeah, thank you. Might as well take the last 5 minutes of this episode. I'm going to put that in Corvo Bianco next to the other trophies we have already. I didn't put the fist fighting trophy there
thank
either.
Thank you very much, Count.
Thank you once more for deigning to take
1,000 crowns, that's actually tournament. Not much.
I hope we shall meet again.
Who knows? Farewell.
Thank you, Count Monnier, and thank you very much. And that is it. Gwent to everything. Turn tournament. We're almost actually at the end of my Witcher series. It's kind of sad to say that. I'm going to try and leave this place. Thank you. Thank you, guards, for keeping the peace. And yeah, we're almost done with The Witcher, because Next episode will probably be the Grandmaster Manticore gear. I have one more side quest for after that. And then maybe I'm going to do, since someone in the comments, kind of forgot his name right now, suggested that I might do another episode about creating some of the builds, especially some of the builds that I've been using for Geralt. But without that, that's probably going to be the last episode. Maybe I do an episode to finish everything off. But we're not going to, sadly, not going to reach 200 episodes. Just shy of 200 episodes. But yeah, I'm just going to go to Corvo Bianco and we'll finish up the episode over there. So, back at Corvo Bianco, I think I can place those trophies in the bedroom, if I'm not mistaken. So, hello, Yennefer. So yeah, we can place one over here. So let's put the Fist Fighting Champion trophy over there. And then I know there's another spot. This spot is taken, obviously, by the joystick award. Yeah, there we go. The Victor's Cup. There we go. Look at that. Three trophies on the shelves. The Gwent trophy, the joystick awards from CD Projekt Red, and then, of course, the fist fighting trophy. So, I'm going to put myself right next to the unicorn here. Thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. Aside from that, next episode will probably be the Grandmaster Manticore gear. And yeah, almost the end of the Witcher series. It's been one hell of a ride, but I'll see you guys next episode. Goodbye. Yeah,